It's something you don't think would ever happen, so you're not prepared for it.
From one second to the next.
When he was out there, I don't think he was paying attention to the depth of the water because it was really shallow.
Luke Fagu's life changed.
He ended up jumping off head first, diving in, and he hit his head on the bottom, and when he did, he was drowning.
Luke's friend Michael Long says Luke never lost consciousness, but he couldn't move after the impact.
My grandpa actually saw it, and he jumped in and he turned him over. They just got a paddleboard and just floated him to shore.
Physical therapist Rob Silavis says 46% of injuries resulting in paralysis happen because of shallow water dives.
And you come into that water and you don't know it's shallow. That's is at the neck and it goes this motion upon impact.
But despite the impact,
it's almost like a shock effect. You really don't feel anything.
Silavis says your brain doesn't know how limited your capacity is in this moment.
So your normal response of trying to pull yourself up, you have no back muscles, you have no tummy muscles, you have no butt muscles, legs are not working.
Silavis says Luke was lucky to have people there to save his life and that these injuries are typically permanent.
Teaching people strategies to maximize what they have.
But that there's always hope.
Nobody can predict the return and the quality of the return.
Luke's friends say he is fighting and on the road to recovery.
Cracking jokes, being same old Luke.
I know you're going to get through this and we're going to help you.
Luke's family and friends are with him at his bedside. The hospital is unsure when he'll be able to return home to Bonita Springs. His family and friends have set up a GoFundMe to get him back to Bonita. Live in the studio tonight, I'm Annalise Garcia, NBC2.